One of the challenges in using products such as Argo, Flux, Elastic, or really any third-party apps for Kubernetes, is making sure that the configs you deploy are written according to the resource schema. In this video, I'm going to show you how to shift left this validation using a tool we built right here at the tree. Stay tuned. Hey again, Adar from the tree here, back with another Kubernetes video. And today we're talking about CRDs and how to validate them. But first, what are CRDs? So CRD, or Custom Resource Definition, is an interface provided by Kubernetes that enables you to define your own resources. Now, CRD itself is a native resource, just like pods, deployments, etc., except it allows you to create non-native or custom resources. And many products in the world of Kubernetes use custom resources to extend the native functionality and to add capabilities that are not provided by native resources. For example, here we have an Argo application. Now, as you probably know, the kind application is not native. So how does Kubernetes know what to do when I apply this resource into a cluster? Well, when installing Argo, what happens behind the scenes is that multiple CRDs, including this one, are installed into your cluster, allowing you to then create and push resources of this kind into your cluster. Now, here's the CRD itself. As you can see, it is of kind custom resource definition, but it defines a resource of kind application, which then allows us to freely create these resources and push them as we please. Just like with native resources, when writing manifests for third-party resources, you also want to make sure that you meet the schema specifications. Otherwise, applying a faulty resource to your cluster will fail. For example, I have an Argo application that is missing a mandatory field. Under spec, all applications must specify the project that they belong to. So let's see what happens when I try to apply this. As you can see, Kubernetes is failing to apply this resource since it has no project defined. And by the way, if you're working with Argo in your organization, I recommend watching this great video by Lukande Mawila that demonstrates how to enforce some best practices in Argo using the tree. Now, all this happened during deployment, which is not ideal. Shifting left schema validation will allow you to catch such mistakes as early as possible and save you a lot of time and resources. Now, schemas can be thousands of lines long, which makes them almost impossible to validate manually. Not to mention that you also need to acquire all the schemas, which can be challenging in itself, and we will address this later in this video. Now, in order to shift left your schema validation, you must use some kind of automated tool, which is why we at the tree built one. As you may know, the tree is a policy enforcement solution that allows you to prevent resources that do not meet your organization's standards from entering your cluster. The tree also offers a CLI tool to shift left these validations by scanning your Kubernetes resources for misconfigurations. Now, this tool also has a schema validation feature that ensures that your resources meet their schema specifications, which can then also be used against custom resources as well. So here we have the same Argo application that we saw before, which has the misconfiguration we showed last time. Now let's see how we can use the tree to find this misconfiguration without actually needing to push this resource into your cluster. So I'll head over to my terminal. Now I already have the tree installed on my machine, so I can just proceed to run the tree test. If you want to look into installing the tree for yourself, see the link in the description. So I'll run the tree test against this file. And as we can see, we fail the Kubernetes schema validation step, which tells us that for field spec, the property project is required, just like we saw before, which is the same message that we got from the Kubernetes server. But hang on a minute. The Argo application is not a native Kubernetes resource, right? So how did the tree know how to validate its schema? Well, the answer is that here at the tree, we created a GitHub repo that aggregates over 100 popular CRDs in the world of Kubernetes, such as Flux, Elastic, Kafka, and many more, along with all of their schemas. So this is what the catalog looks like. And of course, you can find a link to it in the video description. So for example, let's take a look at the Argo application schema, which we used to test our resource before. So this is what it looks like. Now, the tree CLI automatically knows to use this repo when testing. So when we ran the tree test against our Argo application before, it automatically accessed the catalog, saw that this schema is available, and used it for the test. So if you're using CRDs that are not available in the catalog, you can still use the tree to validate them. But first, you would need to acquire their schemas. Luckily, we have a solution for that too. Going back to our CRDs catalog repo, if we scroll down, we can see that there's another tool available here called a CRD extractor. Now, what this tool will do is it will extract all the CRDs from your cluster and save them locally to your machine. And the tree will then know to use them, just as we saw with the catalog. The tree will also know to use your extracted schemas automatically when using it to test. So let's see what this looks like. Going back to my terminal, I can run the CRD extractor on my machine. Great, now as we can see, four CRDs were extracted. Three of them belong to Argo, and since I have Argo installed on my machine, these are the three CRDs that come with it, along with another CRD that belongs to GKE. Now all four of these CRDs were successfully saved to my machine, and from this point on, if I run the tree test against any resource of one of these types, it will automatically know to use these schemas to validate them. If you use CRDs in your own projects that you think other people might also want to use, feel free to open a pull request in our CRDs catalog, so it will be much easier for others to just go ahead and use them in their own projects. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked this video, and I'll catch you in the next one.